Yo, yo, yo. Fuck. I didn't mean to stream or to queue for a quick match. Luckless, Lovelocks here, playing some Heroes of the Storm. Just got back from the Mayweather Pacquiao fight. Pretty disappointed. I'm a big boxing fan, and the event was. If I was to use one word to describe it, it'd probably be boring or disappointing. The undercard's really bad. They featured really good fighters, really good up-and-coming fighters that had an opportunity to showcase their skills, but were matched against fighters that were just totally, totally outmatched. Like, I don't know where they found these guys. Probably the most exciting fight, though, was the Leo Santa Cruz fight, although it was one-sided. The guy who was fighting against, I can't remember his name, was, he did a pretty good job at counterpunching, and he had okay defense, but just not at the same level as, Leo Santa Cruz. And, so the Mayweather-Pacquiao fight, I would say that what I told most people is that Mayweather didn't lose the fight, but he also didn't really win the fight, in the sense that, fine, he didn't get hit with anything great except for, I think there was one good left hand that Pacquiao landed, but he also didn't really do any damage to Pacquiao. And we're talking about a smaller guy with not the best defense. So, like, we really wanted to see, Mayweather really win the fight. He didn't really do it. So, anyway, I just wanted to see an entertaining fight, and I found it to be pretty fucking boring.
The fittest shall survive.
Fuck, there's no one mid. Let's go mid. I had a good time though. I got together with some friends. We watched a fight, we talked, people I hadn't seen for a while. And I had fun. I'm glad I didn't spend $100 on this, to order this fight, because it just did not live up to its potential. Like, even the Lewis. Oh god. Even the Lewis Tyson fight. It was probably more of a mismatch, but at least it had some drama, right? I mean, Tyson was, really entertaining in the lead-up. Lewis ended up knocking him out, which was to be expected. And it was way more of an event. And these guys were, boring to the lead-up, boring during the fight, especially Mayweather. Anyways, I hope they... I think Mayweather's gonna fight him again, and I hope that Pacquiao, pressures from the first round, and he doesn't stop until he gets knocked out. I hope he just pressures until he gets knocked out. If he's gonna get knocked out, I should at least try. I should probably drop some of these things.
Head to a healing fountain before it is too late.
Anyways, I'm gonna concentrate on the game now. That's my take on the fight. Mayweather didn't lose, but I didn't really feel like he won the fight either. Do you know what I'm saying? If you disagree with me, let me know. Crashing. god. Yeah, I meant to queue for Hero League. It's queued for Quick Matchmaking. And I just bought, what's his name? Zagara. So I'm still learning how to play him. I should look up his top build. I'm not gonna pretend like I'm good at theory crafting heroes. I'm not. I think my main strengths are map awareness, maybe. And, teamwork, I guess. I'm not the fastest player in the world, but I have decent reaction time. I played a lot of Dota 2. This game's quite a bit... I'm not gonna say easier, but quite a bit more simple than Dota 2. Oh. Didn't mean to pick that one at all. But I'm not really taking this game seriously. It's really mean to queue for this non-hero league. Not that I'm not gonna try, but. Usually I use this for this, mode to play like heroes that I've not played before, or try out new things. Just kind of, it's one of the problems with this mode, but I think it's kind of necessary. You need a mode to be able to try things out without. Without messing with your rank, I guess. Not that I'm. Most players, like, why should we give a shit about a rank? Like, who cares? We're not professional players or anywhere near it. Oh fuck, I have 10 coins. We're pretty behind on levels here. I think that's the ult to go with. I haven't... Even when I played Zag 4, I bought him, like, before the... before the beta. It's kind of the default ult I would pick. Zag's good, because you can... You can stay in lane consistently because of, he's a creep tumor. Allows you to heal. Gives you movement speed. But, I have a lot of work to do on this guy, for sure. And I think the hero kind of encourages you to not team fight a bit. Without question. Probably a fucking horrible play. That was super inefficient. But hey, we got our fucking coins in, so whatever.
Head to a healing fountain before you bleed out.
Cunning. Anyway, so let me know if you what you think about what you thought about the Mayweather Pacquiao fight. If you're a fight fan, curious to hear. Been a fan of boxing since like the mid-90s. The first fight that I saw that I really liked, that really got me into it, was Johnny Tapia fight against Johnny Ramiro, who was a kind of like a local local rival. And I was so, like, I was so intrigued by Johnny Tapia's style that I just, like, I kind of fell in love with the sport. And if you've never seen Johnny Tapia fight, you gotta see it, because the guy fights with, like, real passion and excitement. And even though he lost a few fights later in his career, he had a really great record, even though he fought with a lot of aggression. So after I saw that fight, and I watched it because my brother was really into it, he was like, you gotta watch this shit. After I watched that fight, I was really into it. And I really, the one thing I like about boxing is that it's individual competition, and it's very physical, because you're, not only do you have to be in really great shape, but you have to be, like, physical shape. You also have to be in really great mental shape. It's like playing tennis for, you know, like an hour, hour and a half, or sorry, like about an hour. But you're also getting hit in the face constantly. You gotta be in great shape, and you gotta be tough as nails. And you gotta be tough as nails mentally. It's like running, like, not running a marathon, but running, like, a long-distance run while getting punched in the face. And that really intrigued me, and I really enjoyed the idea that you've got poor people that have a way to work themselves out of poverty. I'm from Canada, and you don't see a lot of poor hockey players, poor people playing hockey to get themselves, you know, out of the streets. But that's like, hey man, that's like the common story with boxing. Not common, but you know what I mean. So I like the idea of the individual, like the idea of, like, poor people getting out of the storylines, like poor people getting out of the hell that they're kind of stuck in, like the idea of, I love the history, the progression of the sport, like it's the first sport that had a black champion before baseball, before, you know, football. Well, football. Football is a relatively new sport. Or any other major sport. Tennis, golf, whatever. So that's really cool. That's why I like boxing. And my favorite fighter right now, that's a tough call. I think real boxing fans don't really have a favorite fighter. I appreciate fighters like Floyd Mayweather, but I mean, you want to see exciting fights. And I think I think Gennady Golovkin's pretty exciting to watch without being, like, well being technically gifted. Without being too boring? Certainly not a boring fighter. So, I don't know, I guess I'd pick him. Klitschko is too boring. Holds too much. Wow, we're like... actually gonna win this shit, I think. I like the vision that Zagara gives. I think it's underrated. And actually, vision in general is underrated in this game. Because it's not as obvious as in games like Dota. Where you actually buy observer rewards to give you vision. So there's a lot of abilities that give vision in this game, but they're not obvious. Like, you don't look at a... the support role is considered to be someone that provides healing in this game, not someone that provides utility and vision in Dota. That's a bit different. When you look at a support player, there's someone that does early game damage, that provides early game crowd control and late game crowd control, vision and pressure and utility. In this game, support players are generally looked at as just people that heal other people. And if it was up to me, I would change the way that heroes are classified in this game. Because it's like, it's supposed to be noob friendly, but it's misleading all the time. And so if it's misleading, you can make it actually worse for new players, because experienced players will see that they're playing the hero wrong, because that's the way they're advertised to be played, and as a result, there's more animosity, and you're more likely to lose the game. Because this is a very much team-oriented game, and if there's one player that's not playing well, then it's hard for the good players to make up the difference. Because you can't carry in this game. Like, you can't. Let's say I, like, fucking own and I get a billion fucking kills in this game. Like I get max kills, most possible. I'm only as powerful as my other teammates. It's not that strong in this game. Sorry, not in this game. I mean in the creep tumor. 200%. It would be even worse if I didn't take that talent.
have victory in death. The clutch is ready to form again.
I kind of like the way that invisibility is handled in this game, though. It's not like you just can't see them unless you have a sentry board. But if you're in the thick of the action, it's pretty hard to tell that there's an invisible hero there. Like, I didn't see that guy at all. You really have to, like, be looking at the screen and see them. I love that siege damage, it's crazy.
Did you think you were rid of me? As you say.
Drop some of these creep tumors inside of turning spots so I can see them turning in. The advantages of having this hero. You need to get away, you can just use this ult here to make it safe.
We move.
He doesn't really take a lot of damage when he's doing working.
You augmented.
Our vengeance will be complete.
So yeah, just one other comment I want to make about the Mayweather Pacquiao fight. I think they're going to fight again. Mayweather has one fight left in his contract with Showtime. Who's he going to fight? Like, he's obviously going to fight Pacquiao. He's going to make the most money, even if he makes less money than this fight. And he's got a pretty good chance of winning again, like a really good chance. So why wouldn't he fight him again? Like, who's he gonna fight? Amir Khan? Amir Khan has at least a good opportunity to beat Mayweather as Pacquiao did, and he's gonna make less money. Someone, and he's an Al Haymon fighter, so maybe that's another opportunity. Who else has he got? Keith Thurman. No one knows who Keith Thurman is. He's even a smaller fighter than draws a smaller audience than Amir Khan, so he's going to make less money, and he hits hard. So, like, what's the point of fighting him? So, who else is there? Not really anyone I can think of off the top of my head. Unless he fights, like, Golovkin. There's no way he's going to take that fight. He's too big. So, yeah. I think I'll fight him again. So, yeah, I think they'll fight again. But I think it'll go the same way. Just like, Manny needs to work harder. And if he gets knocked out, he gets knocked out. But he's gotta just like, he's gotta fucking try harder, man. To get knocked out losing. And for the, get some better undercards. Man, those undercards are bad. Like, I want to see Lomachenko. I want to see Santa Cruz. But I want to see them fight against fighters that could actually beat them. Play ATC.
I'm here to help.
I had a really good game as ETC, last night, I think it was.
Anytime you're ready.
I bring pandemonium.
I haven't seen a Chen in a while. I like Chen then.
I bring the mega death.
From order comes justice.
My hatred is unending.
I stand ready.
What? Oh. I don't want to play as ETC. I don't usually want to play as warriors, but for some reason I want to play as ETC.
I bring the Mega Death.
I stand ready.
Anytime you're ready.
Grab some water.
Locked and loaded.
From order. Comes justice.
What the fuck? Twice in a row? That's fucked up. Just talking to, texting with my brother about the fight.
curse.
I stand ready.
For the Frozen Throne!
Ready for adventure!
Oh.
I will fight to my last breath!
I heed the voice of Elune.
Victory for the Forsaken!
I hear the call.
Done.
All right, I'm giving you 10 seconds.
The moment is upon us. snake. For me. Of course.
Seems we've reached an accord. Let's show your enemies a jolly good time. Choose a talent.
I'm here.
You require.
What are you waiting for?
Head to a fountain.
Fire!
My will is my own. The moment is lost. The penalty for treason is death. Course. course. Moment is upon us. It's time to kill the spirit.
That had to hurt.
My good kill there. Is upon us.
Looks like you just lost a farm. Looks like your soul beat you to it. Let this be a lesson to you.
I'm here. Test my patience.
Pop, you're in the mood for some treasure, matey. We're on, boys. Let's liven up this place.
Give the order. My will is my own. May my aim be true.
Apart.
I'm here.
We don't be working for free!
Done.
Your enemy has it out for you!
Of course. Do not test my patience.
And heroes on a dead man's chest. Yo-ho-ho! Hey! You stole me, Bob!
None shall evade my wrath.
mood for some treasure, matey?
My will is my own. The moment is upon us.
This mercenary camp.
Forward.
Let's liven up this place!